Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm going to do a quick review of factoring techniques. Here's the list of problems that I'm going to go over in this video. Factoring out a common factor, factor by grouping, a trinomial where A is equal to 1. A refers to the coefficient in front of that lead term. Factor a trinomial where A does not equal 1. You can see that here we don't have 1s there. And factor a difference of squares. So if you already know how to do these and you don't feel like you need a review, then maybe move on to the next video. For those of you that would like a review, here's our first example. We're going to look at taking out a common factor. And in this problem, we're saying what numbers do they have in common? They both have a 7, so that's what's going to go in front of our parentheses. They both have at least 1x, so that's going to go here. And then they both have at least 5y's. We always use the smallest power to when we're factoring. And so I'm going to divide both of these by 7xy to the fifth. And what I'm going to get here is the 7's cancel. I have one extra x, and I don't have any extra y's, so I just have x. In the second one, 14 over 7 is 2. I don't have any x's, but I have 2 additional y's, so I have y squared. Remember, you can always check your factoring by distributing. If you multiply this back through, you should get what you started with. For the second one, we're going to talk about factor by grouping. When we're factor by grouping, we want to group our terms, and sometimes in harder problems, you have to rearrange to get these to factor. For this one, we're just going to group them, the first two together and the second two together. Notice that there's a plus in between. What's the common factor for this binomial? Well, they both have a 3 and they both have a b. So I'm dividing both of these by 3b, and that's going to leave 4a. And over here, dividing by 3 gives me 3. No b's left, so that's it. In the second set, what do I have in common? Well, I'm going to put that plus down here. And I have a 2 in common. If I divide both things by 2, I get 4a minus 3. This is what I want to happen. I want to happen that my binomials match. Once I do, I say, oh, what does this have in common? Well, they both have a 4a minus 3, so that's what I'm writing out front. So I divide by 4a minus 3. I'm always dividing by what they have in common. That cancels to 1 and that cancels to 1. And so what I have left is 3b plus 2. Remember, you can always check by multiplying. If I wanted to, 4a times 3b is 12ab. Negative 3 times 3b is negative 9b. 4a times 2 is 8a. And negative 3 times 2 is negative 6. So that checks out. All right, let's look at two more examples here. Factoring trinomials. The way that I show you how to factor is the box method. If you don't like the box method, go on YouTube and say factor trinomials, and you will see many other ways to do this. When you factor a trinomial, what you're shooting for is to break that down into two binomials. And the way I would show you to do it, this one, of course, has a 1 in front of my p squared, which makes it a little easier. First term goes over the first column. Your last term goes over your second column. And that middle term, including the signs here, goes down below. Okay, so now what I would suggest to you is to use a pencil if you're new to factoring. So I'll use a pencil. P squared is going to have to be p times p. There's no other way to get p squared. And then I have to find something that multiplies to be 27. Well, I could use 1 and 27, but I'm trying to get to 6. So it kind of makes sense to me that I'm going to use 9 times 3. But which one of those should be negative? Because this should be a negative 27 and this should be a negative 6. If I multiply straight across, I get 9p and 3p. Now I can see, oh, obviously, I need to have 9 negatives and 3 positives to get 6 negatives. So it's negative 9. We never put a negative in that first column. My answer comes off the diagonal, p minus 9 and p plus 3. As always, you can multiply to check this. P times p is p squared plus 3p minus 9p minus 27 is p squared minus 6p minus 27, which is what we started with. Okay, let's look at our next example. This one obviously more complicated. I still want to get to this breakdown like this, but I want to see what I have here. Well, I have 5a squared up here. I have positive 3 here. And down below, I have a positive 8a. If you write your signs, you're less likely to mess them up. Well, the nice thing here is that 5a can only be 5a times a. There's no other way to get 5a squared, so that's pretty nice. And the other nice thing is that I can only do 3 times 1. Now, let's say I did 3 times 1 like that. I would get 15a and 1a, and that's never going to get me to 8. But before I give up on those, I want to switch this. Maybe 1 and 3 is just needs to be rearranged. So I put 1 on top and 3 on the bottom. Now if I multiply across, I get 5a and 3a, and that does add up to 8a. And in this case, they're all positive, so that's nice. My answer is on the diagonal, and it doesn't matter which one I put first. But one of those has to be a plus 1, and the other one has to be 5a plus 3. Again, multiply that out to check it. 5a times a is 5a squared. Then I have plus 3a plus 5a and plus 3 for my last term. And then it gives me 5a squared plus 8a plus 3. What I want to show you is when you use the box method, what are you getting? Well, you're getting that 5a squared, the 3a, the 5a, and the 3. Those terms are all around there, which is another way to check it, looking at your box method. Okay, two more examples. The first one is another one that has a trinomial that has an a that is not equal to 1. And so we're going to then take this box method. Again, use a pencil in case you make a mistake. You can erase. You don't always get it right the first time. First term over the first column, last term over the last column. And minus 2t goes down there. Well, I know that 3t squared can only be 3t times t because 3 is a prime number. And let's say that I want this to be 3 and 7. I'm trying to get negative 2t. Then I can multiply straight across and I would get 9t and 7t. Would that ever possibly get me to negative 2? Yes. And I need to remember that these two things should have multiplied to negative 21. So which one of those should have been negative? Well, I want negative 2. So the 9 would be negative, which means the 3 is negative. I never put a negative in that first column. Negative 9t and positive 7t adds up to negative 2t. So here's my answer on the diagonal, t minus 3 and 3t plus 7. Again, multiply that out, and you'll see you get 3t squared, you get plus 7t, minus 9t, minus 21, and those t terms are going to give you that negative 2 in the middle. And the last one is the difference of squares. The difference of squares formula is x plus y and x minus y when you have a difference of squares. Instead of x, we have 25x, so that's going to be 5x and 5x. Whoops, 5x. And then we have 1, that's going to be 1 and 1. And the rule is you have 1 plus and 1 minus. It doesn't matter which one you write first. This is just written sloppy, but these are the same thing, right? We have 25x squared is 5x times 5x. What happens to your middle terms and your inside and outside terms here? You've got negative 5x and positive 5x. Those two things cancel out, which is why we don't have a middle term when we look at this. All right, I don't know why that's happening. All right, so have a fantastic day, and we'll talk to you next time.